بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. All perfect praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. I testify that there is none worth of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his slave and messenger. The condition of women in the world before Islam was very bad. Women were treated like slaves or property, and their personal consent concerning anything related to their well-being was not considered important. They had no independence, they couldn't own any property, and they weren't allowed to inherit. It is Islam that gave women their due rights and made them equal to men. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "An-nisa'u shaqa'iqur rijal." Women are the sisters of men. Islam considers a woman to be equal to a man as a human being and as his partner in this life. Those who always convince a woman to show her body and to expose it to the public are wrongly demeaning the woman by enjoying her body. A woman is rewarded for her deeds just like a man. If she does anything whose reward is a house in paradise, then she gets it. The fact that if a woman enters paradise, she'll be a wife to one of its inhabitants, does not prevent her from having her own house in paradise. For example, our mother Khadija radiallahu anha was given glad tidings of a house in paradise, even if she's with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in paradise. Dear sisters, we should therefore strive to seek the right path and work hard to enter the paradise, just like the way men do. It's okay for a woman, just like it is for a man, to ask Allah to bless her with a house in paradise. قال تعالى وضرب الله مثلا للذين آمنوا امرأة فرعون إذ قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة ونجني من فرعون وعمله ونجني من القوم الظالمين. Allah informed us in His book about the wife of Fir'aun that she said, "My Lord, build for me near you a house in paradise and save me from Fir'aun and his deeds and save me from the wrongdoing people." The fact that Allah the Almighty distinguished men with some features and abilities, not for women, does not justify the negligence of the deen on the side of the women. Men go to jihad and fight in the will of Allah. Men perform prayers 5 times daily in the masjid with their friends, which gives them so many opportunities, including but not limited to exchanging ideas between one another and sharing life experiences. The same applies to weekly Jummah prayers, which is also mandatory for them to perform it. This does not mean that the paradise is only meant for men and that women should not bother to work for the same paradise. We should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has distinguished women with some features and abilities not for men as well. Your jihad as a woman is giving birth to a child, something which is only comparable to death, and no man can ever involve himself in this jihad. And if you die as a result of this battle, you die a shahida, you die as a martyr of this deen. Take a good care of your family. You are an expert at this. No man will ever challenge you as a mother. Pray your 5 daily prayers at home. Fast your month of Ramadan. Guard your chastity. You'll enter paradise from any gate you wish. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.